Thank you for joining me. This week we lectio the liturgy with the collect for the third Sunday in Ordinary Time. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The prayer sounds pretty straightforward this week, but as usual, there's more than meets the eye. This week, we have one of my favorite elements, an accru. That is the clue that we have something special to gain in the prayer. Because of the conjunction that, or sometimes it's so that, the do is an independent phrase, and the accru is the dependent phrase. To ask God to direct our actions to His good pleasure is a great prayer, and it can stand on its own. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, period. However, there are a few important notes. These actions are not our ideas. We're not asking God to bless what we want to do. Have you ever been to a church meeting and heard, "Here's our plan, Lord, please bless it"? These actions are God's idea, and the first prayer we should say is, "Lord, make my will be your will." Let's look at our friend Jonah. We'll hear about him in the first reading this weekend. Nineveh got to stay on the map because Jonah eventually followed God's plan. The people of Nineveh repented and their souls were spared. So many good things, all because Jonah said yes to God's plan. However, we have more to gain. In Jesus' name, we can abound in good works. This phrase is dependent because we can't abound to be over and above in good works without God directing our actions. These works have been prepared for us in advance. We're going to look at Ephesians 2:10. We have the choice, just like Jonah did. Do we walk in the good deeds that God has for us, or do we follow our own plan? If you're wondering, how can this make a difference in your life? The answer is life-changing. When we are abounding in the good works of God, we become the person He intended us to be, and others will see God at work in our lives. This week, as we lectio the liturgy, spend some time with Ephesians 2, verse 10. For we are His handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. What has God put before you? What is He calling you to do? Does the realization that it might be something God has put before you to build the kingdom change the way you see it? I pray it makes you excited to complete the task. Thank you for praying with me, and I pray you have a blessed week.